by Farouk Martins Arsa. Does anyone remember or know the saying that on your way up, remember those you climbed on because you may need them on your way down? It is never easy for African Americans in the managerial or supervisory positions as the lonely ones or when they are the minorities. Get this straight, you are supposed to be the sharpshooter and the shield against criticism, justifiably or not. Damn if you push back, damn if you don't. It is a balancing act and you may still fall or fail. It is immaterial whether Omarosa E is an African American, Kenyan or Nigerian, her skin color commands the same indifference. There are those that would not take direction from her, no matter how sweet she is. They may like it if she baked cookies and brought it to work or had the best candies in a jar on top of her table for everyone. Any black in a managerial position that told you she has never encountered racism or disrespected, is stingy with the truth. Johnny L. Carcra Jr. The late famous O.J. Simpson's lawyer had been the prosecutor defending police officers against many black criminals complaining about police brutalities. He got sick and tired of doing that and became a defense attorney that finally got O.J. Simpson exonerated in a highly controversial case because of police unfair and sometimes outrageous tactics. When you manage a system that is indifferent to the welfare or justice for your people, be careful. Africans or first-generation Africans like Obama also face additional tasks to overcome. Some African Americans wage a tribal storm in a teacup against them. You are better off if you ignore them and face the bigger tasks. It was the job of Omarosa to defend the president whom she later claimed had racial attitude but not a racist. African Americans seized upon making that distinction without a difference to justify their disdain for knowingly defending her boss. Images, Facebook. Why did it take the end of her job, resignation or outright firing to start speaking out? Some African brothers say the job was too good to quit. Omarosa do have other qualifications and qualities, but she got the job because of her affiliation to the highly rated show Apprentice, You Are Fired. Others claimed she had no qualitative duties as African Americans outreach director of communication that were very offended each time she defended the administration. Let us be fair, it was a political job and anyone the president so desired could have got that job. If it comes to keeping a job, Africans know how to keep their jobs than African Americans. It has nothing to do with competency. It's the difference between their feeling as a right and not a privilege. This could be worse when unqualified African American assumes that a well-qualified first-generation African should not get the job since there are African Americans. Unfortunately, even someone as highly informed and educated as the only African American in cabinet, Drive. Ben Carson thinks President Obama does not have the gerational experience of African Americans. So, it is not only some whites that thought Obama should not be president, some African Americans thought so too.